when she's jamming. She talks about revolution, genocide, and famine. She's the girl of the slam, and damn it, I think she's slamming. But I got rejected. I don't know why I even thought that I could nag a slam poet who chose to rock a bow mic.
The first time I saw her on the mic, I thought that she was so hot.
I gave her a love poem, but I couldn't find her flow spot, so I didn't get no love. Men don't really have no luck. She said she wasn't into boys or nothing. She just thought my poem sucked. Her way she had me hooked in that superb oratory.
I knew then poetry is the ultimate aphrodisiac.
Yeah. What was it like when you're at the microphone?
You can't make out with the microphone.
And I'd rather just make out with you.
She felt the same way. I must say, you're so pretty. It's obvious you were born with two X chromosomes. Even if you weren't, it's so not a deal breaker.
Because I respect you as a woman. But
I bet if I did, it would be awesome! I don't care if there's enough significant tattoo to the roof of your mouth. If you don't mind, I would like to greet it with my tongue. Your eyes.
I'm like spheres of beauty.
See, bro.
And your size puncture the ball lines of my ambivalent peripheries.
Most of all,
this poetry makes me jealous of that wrinkly handkerchief you wear. Because I want to be the one hanging around your neck all sweaty
and dirty
and so obviously indie.
Our first day when we ride our fixed gear bikes in here is independently owned or get up, you grow?
Vegan friendly.
Our first skin tight jeans. In between bikes is finished out with
vegan feta cheese.
You can tell me, you think hipster culture will be the end of humanity and how you refuse to label your sexuality. But I won't really be listening.
And all I can think is how I'm in love with the humidity of your heroic similes.
I'm in love with your punk rock pacing.
I'm in love with your perfect timing and stage presence. I'm just saying,
I want to be the one to make you scream out so your vocal cords get sore nowhere near a stage.
Although it's true, I sometimes fantasize about unwrapping her. After much thought, I realized I wasn't attracted to her, but that spectacular vernacular kept me going after her.
But by definition, love and lust has more tangibility than this poem confusion. I wonder if you ever get jealous of your words.
If you know that it's a hard fall from pedestals and stages.
Love is a far cry from notebook pages. I have a crush on what you do to a microphone.
But I don't want to go home with you. I want your words to take me home with them. I don't love you like I love your pen. And I've always thought haikus were the best kind of foreplay.
It will lead to late birth sticking against my tongue.
Oh, no.
Fingernail scratch mark conflict. Illicit encounters in deserted parks.